What's up, everybody? Welcome to 6 Minute Horror Movie Reviews, where I review a typically lesser-known horror movie in about 6 minutes. Spoilers will be contained throughout this video, so if you have not seen this movie or wish to not have the events of this movie spoiled for you, click off this video. But if you're okay with spoilers, let's begin. Today's film is Alice, Sweet Alice, released in 1976 and directed by Alfred Soul. The film takes place in 1961 and focuses on a young girl named Alice, who becomes the suspect of a series of murders that followed the death of her sister Karen. Karen was strangled and burned during a Catholic church service when she was about to be given her first communion. Alice's sister Karen was the favorite child, and there is a stigma surrounding Alice since she was conceived out of wedlock. She is certainly a little bastard. She's full of anger and angst, though the film makes us somewhat sympathetic to her struggles in life. She's not treated fairly by her divorced mother and her estranged father. Alice often wears a yellow raincoat and a translucent mask, and it's someone wearing this same outfit that's committing the murders. Is it Alice? Well, I can't stress enough that you should watch this movie before having anything spoiled for you. This is one worth the watch before having it spoiled, but if you really want to know what happens, let's dig in. So after Alice's sister is strangled to death and burned at the church, she's suspected of being involved. Alice's Aunt Annie moves in to help around the apartment. The apartment is it's a decent enough place considering it's ran by a morbidly obese pedophilic landlord named Mr. Alfonso. On the stairway, Aunt Annie is stabbed violently by someone in a translucent mask and a yellow raincoat. She survives the horrific ordeal, but only barely, as Alice's mother Karen hears her screams and arrives to rescue her and have her sent off to the hospital. Aunt Annie claims that it was Alice who tried to kill her, as Alice and the aunt do not get along. Alice is then sent off to an institution for a psychological evaluation. Alice's father later received a phone call from who he is told is Aunt Annie's daughter, who needs to see him about a matter involving the death of his daughter Karen. He rushes to the location, an abandoned, dilapidated building which should raise some red flags, but hey, not everyone can be the brightest bulb in the box, right? Of course it's a setup, and Alice's father is stabbed, bound in rope, and just before he's tossed off a ledge to certain death, we find out that the killer is actually Mrs. Trudoni, the lady who is the caretaker of the Monsignor and Father Pat. Earlier in the film, she had seen Alice wearing the yellow raincoat and the translucent mask, and she carried out the series of attacks, convinced that the angsty, untrusted Alice would take the fall. Her motive is explained further as she's a religious lunatic who's punishing the family for their sins of premarital sex and divorce. Then Alice's father is pushed off the ledge to his death. Alice's mother goes to the home of Father Pat, but is instead greeted by Mr. Trudoni, who invites her in and freaks her the fuck out by telling her that her daughter died before her first communion because she and her husband had sinned. Father Pat then arrives to let Catherine know that her ex-husband has been found dead. This clears Alice as a suspect considering she's been locked up in an institution. Upon returning home, she plays a prank on the creepy landlord by placing a jar of cockroaches on his belly as he naps on his couch. He wakes up and freaks out after seeing the sight of the roaches. As soon as she leaves, Miss Trudoni, wearing the exact same uniform of a yellow raincoat and a mask, arrives on the staircase where the landlord attacks her, suspecting that she was Alice who played the prank, and he gets stabbed to death. Mrs. Trudoni is then seen maskless fleeing the scene by a detective who has been working the case. The police are notified, and Miss Trudoni is confronted by Father Pat at a church service just before she can receive communion. She loses her mind at the thought that Alice and her mother received communion and she did not, and stabs Father Pat in the throat. Fucking brutal. The congregation flips out as Father Pat slowly bleeds to death in Miss Trudoni's arms. In all the fuss, the movie ends with Alice picking up the bloody knife, sliding it in her bag, and looking into the camera with a sinister stare. This movie is shockingly good for having essentially no reputation. I hadn't even heard of this movie until a few weeks ago. It definitely ranks pretty high as a 70s slasher. The stabbing scenes are very brutal and realistic, especially the scene where Aunt Annie is stabbed on the staircase. Her screams are horrific as the killer continues to attack her. Of course I'm going to talk about pacing, and this is yet another reason I fucking love 70s horror. There was never a dull moment in watching this film. It stays interesting and keeps you on your toes. For most of the movie, I was stuck thinking that it must be Alice committing the murders, because if it isn't, how do they explain someone else wearing the exact same outfit and matching the size of a young girl? Well, they pull it off, and they gave the killer a crazy yet believable and not convoluted motive. They delivered on the suspense and the violence big time. And like that, this movie became one that I've added to my collection. I'd give Alice, Sweet Alice an 8.5 out of 10. It delivers the goods in a very unique way. The plot, the characters, the suspects and murders, it all feels original and very well done. It doesn't have some huge body count where the corpses just pile up, but every death and every violent attack has a lot of weight to it. It's a 70s slasher which sort of has the feel of Black Christmas. And like Black Christmas, it's crazy underrated. In fact, I'd say it's one of the most underrated horror movies of the 70s. Well, that wraps it up for this one, but more are on the way. And as for the video, if you like it, give it a like. For the channel, if you like what I'm doing here, be sure to subscribe for more content. And with YouTube fucking up how subscriptions work, be sure to hit the bell and click show all notifications to be reminded when new content like this is available. And if you really love what I'm doing, you can support the channel on Patreon. The link is in the description. But until next time, later everybody.